Hi! It is time to test the strongest lasers in my collection. I will test both power and wavelength for all laser colors I own, including the mighty Hercules laser starring in many of my videos, down to some small ones I have never shown before. Is bigger better? Well, some will disappoint, while others will shine. Lots of strong lasers incoming. Some of them in the highest safety class, class 4. Protect your eyes. Wear laser safety glasses for the correct wavelength. First of all, thanks to my patrons for helping out with the laser power meter and the spectrometer. This gem is brand new to my channel. It measures the incoming light spectrum and even let us see well into ultraviolet and infrared with high precision. The lasers will reveal how precise it measures. I went for the version with an extended range but lower resolution since I want to detect, well, I will show you later in the video. Let's go ahead with the test. And why not start off with the laser I featured in my very first video over 11 years ago. An up to 200 milliwatt strong red laser. For all tests, I'll use new or freshly recharged batteries to give the lasers the best chance of high power. Here's the test bench. I will point the laser beam at the laser power meter sensor and point a spectrometer sensor at the laser dot. Okay, not quite 200 milliwatts, but I'm just glad it even works, being at least 11 years old. It appears to be a 660 nanometers diode, running a little hot at around 662 nanometers. Not the cleanest spectrum we will see. Here is a way more modern laser and one of the newest wavelengths available, 505 nanometers. 37 milliwatts, not bad, and within the cellular spec. The peak wavelength is also laser spot on at 505 nanometers, with a little secondary peak at 507. It is always nice with new exotic laser colors like this one. It just isn't my favorite color. For me, it's like a green that wants to be cyan and ends up being a pastel tone green. Why not go full cyan like this 488 nanometers laser? It is marked as a 60 milliwatts laser and turns out to be 67 milliwatts. I'm happy about that. And the wavelength too. It peaks at 490 nanometers and has a nice clean spectrum around the center. Nothing to complain about here. Let's go even shorter in wavelength, all the way down to the edge of ultraviolet with a 405 nanometers Blu-ray laser. This is sold on eBay as a 500 milliwatts engraving laser. Considering how cheap it was, I doubt it specs. The truth is... Oh, hello! Looks like I won in the eBay lottery. This actually is close to 500 milliwatts. And the clean spectrum too, around a 404 nanometer center, indicating decent cooling on the 405 nanometers diode. Winner, winner! From one end of the visible light spectrum to the other. This is my very first laser pointer, dating back to the previous millennium. Look at the wear on the label. It uses an early red laser diode that's not far from being infrared. Only 3 milliwatts, but a nice deep red color at 672 nanometers, not that far from the invisible infrared. And speaking of infrared, here is one of my invisible lasers. I can only see if this is turned on or not if I use an IR detector card. It is weaker than advertised, but over 100 milliwatts of invisible laser beam is still scary. Not recommended for beginners. It peaks just short of 980 nanometers. No wonder it is invisible to my eyes, but not to the spectrometer. Before we test the really strong lasers in my collection, I would like to show you the oldest laser I own. A helium neon laser from 1988. It barely works, but should just be able to laser enough to measure its wavelength. Helium neon lasers have a very precise and clean spectrum, which should be tightly centered around 632.8 nanometers. This will be the real test of whether I can trust the spectrometer or not. Ideally, I should have measured this in a darkened room with my body heat behind the sensor, but looks like around 1 milliwatt, a quarter of what it used to be 30 years ago. Nothing wrong with the beam quality though. Look at this tight peak. Can I trust the spectrometer? Is this close to the actual 632.8 nanometers? Yes! With a 1 nanometer resolution on the spectrometer, this is as good as it gets. It's only a third of a billionth of a meter off. And look how clean the peak is, with steep sides and no secondary peaks. Beautiful! I love this result. It gives me full confidence in the spectrometer's readings. Click like to celebrate it with me. Switching from precision to power, it is time for the big boys. Well, this laser is not big as such, but don't let its small size fool you. While its wavelength may be close to the helium neon lasers, its power is not. It has a multi-mode laser diode, so forget about beam precision. On eBay, it is sold as being under 5 milliwatts, as usual, but labeled as under 500 milliwatts. Guess how powerful it really is. Wow, it is a 700 milliwatts class 4 laser. The spectrum is not as impressive, being relatively wide and with two almost equally strong peaks. Typical multi-mode diode with a wider spectrum than single-mode diodes. And now for my strongest one diode laser, a blue one. Going above 1000 milliwatts, 1 watt of optical laser power output used to be hard and expensive, until we invented 445 and 450 nanometer diodes. This one should easily pass 1 watt. How high will it go? I am starting at the lowest power level and will ramp it up by holding the power button in. The 2 watt max is a bug in the laser power meter. I have a video about it on Patreon. Looks like it is max 1.25 watts. High, but I was expecting higher since the seller measured it to average 1.49 watts back in 2014. Has it lost that much power over 6 years? The wavelength is, however, very close to the nominal 445 nanometers. I then realized that I let go of the power button when the third LED lit up, indicating high power mode, but maybe it wasn't at full power. Let me try holding it for longer. There we have it. It is close to 1.5 watts. Awesome. After heating up, the diode is now emitting 446 nanometers. Direct diode lasers typically increase in wavelength with higher temperature and vice versa. Alright, I can't hold it off anymore. It is time to measure the mighty Hercules. I'm a little nervous about this one. It is by far my most expensive laser, and I bought it 12 years ago, second hand. It is very easy to pot mod to turn the power up or down on it. I have fiddled a little with it myself, but tried to put it back exactly where it was when I bought it. But what if the first owner fiddled with it too? Does this laser still emit around 425 milliwatts in average? With the best D cells the local store has, I'm hoping to see over 400 milliwatts, but I could easily be disappointed. Fingers crossed, please. I know this will slowly warm up, so I'm not too worried yet. Come on! Above 400, please. You can do it. Hmm. Yes. There was no reason for me to worry. After warming up, it is solidly above 400, so it can still be called a Hercules 400 here in its teenage years. The spectrum is not the cleanest, but the peak is very close to the 532 nanometers usually quoted for a green DPSS laser. In the official specs, this Hercules peaks at 531.65 nanometers. Seems confirmed to me. But you may have spotted some other peaks. This is the main reason why I chose the version of the spectrometer with extended range. I want to detect the infrared leakage from green lasers. I am surprised to see a little 1064 nanometers leakage from the Hercules. In a previous video, I saw no signs of leakage at all, but the spectrometer is sensitive enough to show a small bump at 1064 nanometers. I even see a tiny peak at around 1152 nanometers, though I have no idea what this could be. Comment if you have a guess or know it. However, I see absolutely no leakage from the 2500 mW infrared 808 nanometer pump diode inside the laser. Very nicely filtered. Here's an example of a poorly filtered green laser pointer. At first, I didn't see much infrared. I think the fiber cable sensor was at a too steep angle, not letting the long wave infrared light have full internal reflection in the glass fiber to reach the sensor inside the spectrometer. With a better angle? Oh boy. That's the spectrum you don't want to see from a green laser. I have more info about the problem in another video. Look at all that invisible infrared light in the beam. A lot of 808 and a little 1064 nanometers. Reveals the DPSS technique and poor filtering, if any, used in this laser. The green laser light starts with an infrared laser diode, like this one. Alright, that is the current rainbow of laser colors in my collection. Let me know in a comment on what wavelengths you have me beat, both in power and additional wavelengths. It is quite incredible what lasers people have at home and not only in labs these days. I would love to hear about yours. Stick around for a bonus laser after this message. Thanks to my awesome patrons for helping out with the expensive but well worth it spectrometer. I wouldn't have it without your support. If you want to help me keep going with the videos too, I have a link for my Patreon page in the description under the video. Thank you. Thank you for watching. Bye for now.